Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Mean Gene Show here on iHeartRadio. This Sunday, the NCAA revealed its tournament bracket for the NCAA March Madness. And this was great news, folks, especially since last year's tournament was completely canceled due to the coronavirus. So this year, to limit the spread of COVID-19, the entire tournament will be played on two courts inside Lucas Oil Stadium, which is located in Indianapolis, Indiana. So they're going to be playing at Lucas Oil Stadium, as well as Bankers Life Fieldhouse. That's where the Indiana Pacers play their home games. Hinkle Fieldhouse, Indiana Farmers Coliseum, Mackey Arena, West Lafayette, and the Simon Scott Assembly Hall in Bloomington. So only one game is going to be played at a time at Lucas Oil Stadium. So this is really going to be interesting. It's really good to see that the NCAA is taking the COVID-19 series. Now, as it relates to fans, the NCAA announced on February 19th it will allow up to 25% capacity with physical distancing in conjunction with local and state COVID-19 policies. So the tournament gets underway Thursday, March 18th, and ends on Monday, April 5th, with the cutting down of the nets and the crowning of an NCAA tournament champion. All right, last night, I completed my bracket, and I'm not saying this is going to be my only bracket, but for the purpose of this show, this is my official Mean Gene NCAA tournament bracket, and here we go. Okay, we're going to start with the West bracket, which has the number one seed, Gonzaga. And just real quick, let's go ahead and look at the four number one seeds. Over in the West is Gonzaga, 26-0, folks, a remarkable year. Now, I did get a chance to see quite a few of Gonzaga's basketball games this year, not all 26 of them, but I can tell you the games that I did see. I mean, this team is very, very competitive, very, very competitive. They play a unique style of basketball that's really, you know, awkward to defend if you're defending. So that's why it's going to be interesting to see, looking at this bracket and some of the teams that they could potentially face getting out of that region. The other number one seed is the Baylor Bears. Now, Baylor, 22-2, only lost two games. And let me tell you, I live here in the Houston area, so I definitely do get a chance to see and keep up with the Baylor Bears. They are also an exciting basketball team. I mean, they were number one up there for a minute before Gonzaga took over. But do not count the Baylor Bears out of this NCAA tournament. And they are the number one seed in the South region, which is an interesting region, and I can't wait to talk about that region. Over in the East, we have the Michigan Wolverines. Now, this is a very, very great story. How about Juwan Howard? I mean, Juwan Howard, who for the longest part, you guys remember his career with the Fab Five there at Michigan. He went on to the NBA and had a great NBA career. Basically, was an assistant coach in Miami for many years and got the call to be the head coach at Michigan. And what a hell of a job he has done. A 20-4 record there in Michigan. And they have the number one seed in the East, which, you know, because all the games are being played in Indiana, I mean, it's and with some fans, and they are on the East, not far from Indiana. So it's going to be interesting to see how many people make the trip up there. I mean, within the 25% limit that the NCAA has granted. The final number one seed over in the Midwest is the Illinois and the Fighting Illini. I have watched them play quite a few games this year, and they are an exciting team too. So I tell you, so there's your number one seeds there. It's Gonzaga, Michigan, Baylor, and Illinois. So this is really, really going to be interesting. The overall number one seed is the Gonzaga team out of the state of Washington. So let's start with the West, folks. Now, you know, it's always interesting. The number one seed and the 16 seed. In this case, you got Norfolk State and Appalachia State, which they're going to play in to see who will have the right to lose against Gonzaga. So I got Gonzaga basically getting out of that bracket, of course. I got Gonzaga facing Oklahoma in the second round. I have Creighton coming out of that bracket. I have Creighton facing Ohio, which is a good team that I have had an opportunity to watch. Now, one of the play-in games is the Wichita State and the Drake team. Now, Drake has been pretty good. Wichita State, a couple of years ago, had an incredible run in the NCAA Tournament. I have Wichita State facing Kansas. Now, Kansas had a good scare. They basically had to drop out of the Big 12 Tournament due to COVID-19 issues, but they will be back. And that team, any Bill Self team, you don't bet against. So I actually have Wichita State going up against Kansas in that second round, and that should be interesting. Also, second round, I have Oregon facing Iowa. Now, this is going to be interesting. Oregon is a 7th seed, and Iowa is the number 2 seed there now. And this is going to be a good matchup. The Oregon Ducks have really had great basketball teams over the last few years. But this Iowa team, not Iowa State, but Iowa team, they're number 2 seed for a reason. So I got a second round matchup. I got Oregon and facing Iowa. And now we will go down to the East. Well, let's just go ahead and finish the West since we're here. Now looking at the next round, which would be the Sweet 16 round, I have Gonzaga beating Oklahoma to advance to the Sweet 16. I have Creighton defeating Ohio to get to the Sweet 16. I have Kansas beating Wichita State to get to the Sweet 16. I have Iowa knocking off Oregon. And as we make it to the Sweet 16, so you're going to have a Gonzaga versus Creighton matchup in the West. I have Kansas and Iowa in the West. Good matchups there. So you have your number 1 seed, Gonzaga. You have Creighton, which is a number 5 seed. I have Kansas, which is a number 3 seed, and Iowa is a number 2 seed. So I think that's pretty fair based on where these guys are seeded and their and the level of play. So advancing to the round of 8, I have Gonzaga in the Elite 8. I have Iowa knocking off Kansas. Iowa, I have a number 2 seed knocking off a number 3 seed to get to the Elite 8. And then from there, I have Gonzaga beating Iowa, and Gonzaga will make it to the Final 4 from the West. That's who I have from the West. So hope you follow that. Hope that makes sense. But I just don't see anyone, even looking at the level of competition, because I had to look at this hard. I had to look at the number 2 seed in this, which is Iowa. I had to look at even the 3 seed, Kansas, even the 4 seed, Virginia. You know, I have Virginia. Let's see here. Where is Virginia? So we got Virginia as the 4 seed. I have Ohio knocking off Virginia. So I made quick work of the 4 seed by this Ohio team is going to be incredible. They're number 13 seed because they won't be going that far once they match up with Creighton. But this is what I have in the West. Okay, Gonzaga is my Final 4 team in the West. So let's go ahead and look at the East, starting off with the Michigan Wolverines. They are the number 1 seed. They will play either Mount St. Mary's or Texas Southern University. Doesn't really matter because they will, win and get to the second round. Have LSU coming out of the first round. They are a number 8 seed. Now, they're going to be playing the number 9 seed, San Bonaventure. But LSU has the SEC was very, very tough down the stretch. LSU made it to the championship game of the SEC tournament. And I mean, just really was very competitive. I mean, 3 teams in that conference, Arkansas, Alabama, and LSU, were just very competitive. And Tennessee, of course, which I think all 4 of those teams made the tournament. So this is going to be a great representation from the SEC. But I do have LSU advancing to the second round. The number 5 seed, Colorado, and the number 12 seed, Georgetown Hoyas. Now, folks, let me tell you, Georgetown won their tournament. And, oh, my goodness, to see Patrick Ewing It sort of reminds me of the Juwan Howard story, because Patrick Ewing also was an assistant coach in the NBA for a very, very long time. Never got the call to be a head coach in the NBA, which was very shocking and surprising. But he went on to coach his alma mater, where John Thompson was his coach, the late, great John Thompson. And, oh, my goodness, you know, we lost John Thompson last year. But, man, he's got to be looking down at Patrick Ewing and blessing him and just watching over him. So I have Georgetown advancing to the second round as a 12 seed knocking off a 5. Now, it happens. It happens. It has happened more frequently here in the last few years where, and I looked at all of the 12-5 matchups in this tournament. You know, even though Winthrop and Purdue won, I'm sorry, the Villanova and Winthrop won, was interesting, as well as the Tennessee and Oregon State. You know, I looked at that, and I said, you know, I don't know, but this one right here, if any 12 seed is going to advance in this tournament, it's going to be the Georgetown Hoyas. So I got them going to the second round. The 4-13 matchup there is Florida State and UNC Greensboro. Got Florida State going to the second round. Can't wait to see that matchup if it happens between Leonard. Forgot his last name. Leonard, the coach out there at Florida State, and Patrick Ewing. That's going to be interesting. But anyway, don't want to get too far. So I do have Florida State as the number 4 seed advancing in the second, making it to the second round. The 6-11 matchup, that's BYU and either Michigan State or UCLA. I got Michigan State. And this is what this each bracket is really going to be very interesting, because you got some powerhouses in this bracket here, including, I mean, look, some of the powerhouses in the East, and Michigan, if they do advance, it's going to be very interesting. I mean, you got Michigan, Georgetown, Florida State, Michigan State, Texas, UConn, and Alabama. All of these teams are in the East bracket. So I'm not going to say who I got coming out of it just yet, but I'm just letting you know the level of competition. And as I look at this bracket here, I mean, and I looked at it all, I think the heaviest competition, folks. I mean, the Midwest might be that way, but there is the level of talent and competitiveness and great teams definitely are coming out of the East. So let me finish here. So we got Michigan State advancing to the second round. Then we got a 3-14 matchup. We got the Texas Longhorns against the Abilene Christian University. I got Texas advancing to the second round. UConn, number 7 seed versus a 10 seed. A 7 seed, 10 seed matchup is always interesting. Now, some of these, you know, were interesting because of the past. The past where there was crowds and these teams were centrally located. You know, you just put, and it still might be that way, but I have UConn advancing. The 7 seed beating the 10 seed. UConn will advance the second round. And then you got the 2 and the 15 seed matchups, and this is definitely not going to be much of a game for Iona. They get to play Alabama. Alabama won the SEC tournament, and interesting stuff. So I would say that Alabama is going to advance to the second round. I mean, there's just no doubt about it. Okay, so let's look at the second round of the East bracket. The second round of the East bracket, I have the number 1 seed Michigan playing against the number 8 seed LSU Tigers. Okay, I have Michigan beating LSU. Now, I tell you what, LSU road tested for sure, especially in that SEC division, SEC tournament. I mean, great competition there. Strangely and oddly enough, folks, there is no Kentucky in this tournament. Can you believe it? No Kentucky in the NCAA tournament. So incredible that they didn't make John Calipari. A John Calipari team is not in the NCAA tournament. It's just breaking news within itself. But anyway, that number 1-8 matchup, I think it's going to be a good game, but I think Michigan will go ahead and advance to the Sweet 16. Over in the next round, and this is the one I was almost getting too excited about, and I am excited about. I just hope it happens here. Leonard Hamilton, that's his name. Leonard Hamilton, the head coach of Florida State. And Patrick Ewing, head coach of Georgetown. Georgetown and Florida State matchup in the second round of the East bracket is going to be epic. There's just no way that you will not stop whatever you're doing to sit down and watch this game. Now, Georgetown is a 12th seed and Florida State is a 4th seed. So now this could potentially be the biggest upset of the second round. Okay, and let me just go ahead and call it. I think this would be an upset. I have Georgetown beating Florida State. Now, I've watched Patrick Ewing struggle with this Georgetown team for a couple of years, and the level of competition that they play in his conference, he hasn't shied away from playing top tier competition, even though it came at the expense of just being blown out or embarrassed, but he's stuck with it. He's got the right players playing for him. They believe in him. And of course, I tell you what, man, he is motivated and this team is really, going to do something special. Now, I don't know how far they're going to go, but it's just going to be interesting. We could have some potentially good matchups there with some great former players and coaches in this NCAA tournament, especially in the East bracket. So Georgetown, I have them beating Florida State. The next matchup in the second round of the East bracket, this is my bracket, okay? Before someone listens and says, wait a minute, have they played already? What the hell is going on there? So Michigan State, 11th seed will face Texas. Now, this is going to be another epic matchup. So you have Tom Izzo and Shaka Smart. Shaka Smart, if you remember, coach VCU. Now, I was at the Final Four in Houston over at NRG Stadium when VCU advanced to the Final Four. Crazy. Unreal. And Shaka Smart was able to capitalize on the success of that team and his coaching to get a top-tier coaching job at the University of Texas. So he's got the Texas Longhorns as a number 3 seed. Man, that is as high as I've ever known the Longhorns to get. It's been a long time since they have had a seed that high. So this is Tom Izzo and Shaka Smart, folks. I got Texas winning. I got Texas advancing. I got Texas, which is the 3 seed, which will knock off that number 11 seed, Michigan State. Okay, I just that's what I have there, and I think that's going to happen. And the final game in the second round in my bracket over in the East, I have UConn, the 7th seed, facing Alabama, the 2nd seed. Now, UConn, I tell you, that name has been very popular when it comes to basketball, men's and women's basketball. UConn has always had great teams. So I think Bobby Hurley is the coach of this team. If it's not Bobby, it's one of them Hurleys is coaching UConn. And then Alabama, winners of the SEC, just great, great coaching. Their style of basketball is that they plan to shoot the ball within 4 or 5 seconds. So never mind the shot clock. When it comes to the Alabama team, they just try to score. I think they average about 80-something, 85 points a game, 80-something like that a game, which is very high for college basketball. So you're going to see this high-powered offense go against UConn. I got Alabama advancing to the Sweet 16 in the East bracket. Let's continue the East bracket. The first matchup in the Sweet 16 from the East, I have Michigan versus Georgetown. So we have Juwan Howard versus Patrick Ewing. I mean, this is incredible. Incredible. Two bigs going against each other. Two former players, great players in college, great players in the NBA, and now they're coaching. I mean, it's just really nice to see this progression, of these guys who decide to stick with basketball and become a head coach. So, oh my goodness, I got Michigan beating Georgetown. Michigan going to the Elite Eight. I'm sorry, that's just the way it's got to be. I got Michigan going to the Elite Eight. The next matchup is Texas and Alabama. Man, these are some great matchups here. Sweet 16 over in the East, Texas versus Alabama. I got Texas. I got Texas going to the Elite Eight from the East. And like I told you, this was not an easy bracket to choose. In this, let's finish out the Elite Eight. So basically what you have here is a Michigan versus Texas. You have a number one seed versus a number three seed. Shaka Smart, and he will go up against Juwan Howard's Michigan Wolverines. Folks, I have Michigan advancing to the Final Four from the East. Michigan Wolverines, the number one seed, advancing to the Final Four from the East. Over in the West, I just picked Gonzaga. So right now, I have two number one seeds in the Final Four, Gonzaga and Michigan, who will suit up. That's the East. That's the West versus the East. Now, let's go over to the South bracket here and look at the number one seed, the Baylor Bears. They're going to take on Hartford. They will advance to the second round. I have the North Carolina Tar Heels. They are the eighth seed. They're taking on the Wisconsin Badgers. Now, Wisconsin has played some great basketball this year. Always do. 17-12 was their record. But North Carolina, it's just tough to go against the Roy Williams team. North Carolina, that tradition, that history there. I do have the eighth seed, North Carolina, advancing to the second round. Villanova and Winthrop. Now, this is a 12 versus a 5 seed here. And Winthrop finished the season 23-1. They only lost one game. And believe me, they are a great basketball team. And I don't know if Villanova is just not the same Villanova that we saw win those championships under Jay Wright. But they're not a bad team. 16-6 on the year. Of course, everyone had to deal with the COVID issues and this, that, and the other. But where, you know, what COVID-19 did to the NCAA this year was just really gave some teams an advantage. So if you, I mean, some teams had to start and stop and, you know, delayed and just had to find teams that would play them. And, you know, some teams were just successful and played a lot of games. Winthrop was one of those teams and only had, I don't know who they lost that one game to, but this is a potential match upset here. And actually, I'm picking Winthrop. Now, I did pick a 12 seed in Georgetown, but Winthrop is not a Georgetown, but Winthrop is still a good team. So I got Winthrop advancing to the second round, upsetting Villanova. The number 4 and 13 seed, the 4 seed is Purdue, 13 seed is North Texas. Man, North Texas, this is crazy. I don't think they made a tournament in over 11 years. Not really known for basketball, maybe football. That's the Mean Green, by the way, if you don't know. That's where my man who played for the Pittsburgh Steelers, Mean Joe Green, attended that school. But basketball is just really interesting to see them advance. They're number 13 seed. They will not beat Purdue. So I got Purdue beating the number 13 seed, North Texas. The next matchup is the 6-11 matchup, Texas Tech and Utah State. I have Utah State. Now, I did the same thing over in the East bracket, but I picked an 11th seed and a 12th seed to advance. I'm doing it again in the, because, I mean, Utah State is not to be, I'm not really impressed with Texas Tech basketball. Now, they might win. And like I said, this is my official bracket here, but I'm probably going to fill out a couple of more, and I'm probably going to flip-flop and advance Texas Tech. So I can be right at the end of the day. But for this is my main one here. And then this is where, you know, brackets become busted on day one of these tournaments here by making picks like this. But I'm going out on a limb. I'm going to have Utah State, the 11th seed, knocking off Texas Tech and advancing to the second round. The next one is a 3-14 matchup. Arkansas Razorbacks 22-6. They finished third. I mean, I'm sorry. They are the third seed, and they will play the 14th seed. And I think they finished third in the SEC tournament because they were knocked off, I think, by LSU and didn't get a chance to play Alabama. So I think they did finish third. That's what I was trying to say there, but they did draw a third seed for the body of work that they did for the entire season, which was incredible. I think they had went on a, 11-12 game winning streak in the SEC. Now, that's something that's hard to do, especially after a start of like 0-4 or something like that. against SEC opponents, but they earned the right to get the number three seed. They will beat Colgate. Colgate 14-1. Haven't played a lot of games there due to COVID-19, so that's probably not going to do well in a tournament, and especially playing top tier competition like the SEC. So Arkansas will advance to the second round. The next matchup, 7-10 matchups are just dead. The NC2A does such an incredible job at picking these 7-10 matchups. The 7th seed and the 10th seed itself is just popular. So I think knowing that these potential, it could be an upset, but it's not really an upset. So Virginia Tech, 10th seed, Florida is the 7th seed. So I got Florida advancing to the second round of that particular matchup there. Then you have the number 2 seed, Ohio State, versus the number 15 seed, Oral Roberts. Years ago, I had one of the coaches for Oral Roberts on my show for the NC2A bracket. So Oral Roberts is still a great basketball school there, but not that good facing a number 2 seed Ohio State team. So I got Ohio State advancing there. So that is the South region. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at the second round of the South region. We have a Baylor, number 1 seed versus number 8 seed matchup, North Carolina. Baylor, North Carolina matchup. I got the Baylor Bears winning that game. All right, I got Baylor defeating North Carolina in the second round. I have Purdue beating Winthrop in the second round. I have Arkansas beating Utah State in the second round to advance to the Sweet 16. I have Ohio State beating Florida to advance to the Sweet 16 in the South region. Now, looking at the Sweet 16, you have a Purdue-Baylor matchup. I got to give it to Baylor, folks. I just don't see Purdue. Purdue, which is the 4th seed, you got a 1-4 matchup there in my bracket here in the South region. I got Baylor advancing to the Elite Eight. Got an Arkansas-Ohio State Sweet 16 matchup. Now, this is going to be pretty damn interesting. Both teams kind of wear the red and white, so good luck trying to identify who's who out there. So this is really, really, my goodness. Now, folks, come on. Okay, so I was born and raised in Arkansas. I'd be damned if I'm going to sit up here and pick Ohio State to beat the Razorbacks. And not just because my heart is with Arkansas in this one, but the level of competition, this team is, Musselman, the head coach, has this team playing some great, 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 great basketball. So this would be a 3 and a 2 seed. So matchups, I got Arkansas advancing to the Elite Eight. I mean, and maybe in my other bracket, I might pick Ohio State, but I do think the Razorbacks are good enough to make the Sweet 16. So that I'm going to stick with, and no matter how many brackets I fill out. So now that brings a matchup of an old Southwestern Conference game. The Arkansas Razorbacks at one time was the only school that was not in the state of Texas, but was a member at the Southwestern Conference, and the Baylor Bears. So this would bring back memories for those people who remember the Southwest Conference. So I have the Baylor Bears and the Arkansas Razorbacks in the Elite Eight. My Final Four selection, the Baylor Bears will beat Arkansas. Baylor will go to the Final Four. So there's my third Final Four pick. Over in the West, I pick Gonzaga. Over in the East, I pick Michigan, who will face each other. And then over in the South, I just pick Baylor to be my third Final Four selection. So now the final Midwest selection of Mean Gene's tournament bracket here. Let's start with the number one. See there, the Fighting Illini, they will take on Drexel. Drexel will not advance. Illinois will make it to the second round. The next game is the 8th seed, 9th seed. So you got Loyola Chicago facing Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech is not to be messed around with, folks. I got Georgia Tech advancing to the second round. Tennessee, the 5th seed, will face they're going to face Oregon State. And this was a tough one because Oregon State has really been road tested out there in the Pac-12. finished the season 17-12, so they got a lot of games in there, despite COVID-19. But they're just not the Tennessee team is really damn good. Rick Barnes, former coach of Texas, way back in the day, used to coach the Longhorns. But Rick Barnes has done a hell of a job with the Tennessee Volunteers. So Tennessee advances to the second round. Oklahoma State, the four seed, will take on Liberty. Now, this could be an upset. Now, I might make it an upset in my other bracket. Liberty is not that bad of a team. 23-5 on the year. A lot of games played. Oklahoma State, 20-8. But this could easily be, in my next bracket, I will pick Liberty to win. But in this particular bracket, I do have the four seed advancing. So, to the second round, and that is the Oklahoma State Cowboys. The next matchup is the sixth seed and the 11th seed. And what a hell of a matchup. It's San Diego State. San Diego State has played some great basketball. If you remember San Diego State, that's where Kawhi Leonard played his basketball. And the Syracuse coached by Mr. Calhoun. The guy has been around for a long time, knows something about basketball. But I got San Diego State advancing there in this round, the sixth seed beating the 11th seed in the first round. The 3-14 matchup is West Virginia, is the third seed. They will take on Morehead State. Morehead State finished the year 23-7. Actually, was a pretty good basketball team. I did follow a lot of their games there. And that whole conference, SWAC conference, was quite interesting this year. But West Virginia, the three seed, will advance over the 14th seed. And then now I do have the seven seed Clemson Tigers and Rutgers, the Scarlet Knights. Rutgers, the 10th seed there. I got Rutgers beating Clemson. Clemson in basketball just hasn't really caught on to me yet. Now, we're not talking football here. But I got the 10 seed beating the 7 seed. Like I said, I like those 7-10 matchups in the NCAA tournament. I'm going with Rutgers to beat Clemson, the 7 seed. And then the number 2 seed in the Midwest bracket is the Houston team, the Houston Cougars, I believe, 24-3, incredible year. Kevin Sampson, what he's doing with that team, even though he had some players that just really dropped and transferred, basically, and still finished the year 24-3 and was ranked in the top 10, I believe, for almost the majority of the entire year. They're taking on Cleveland State, the 15th seed, so Houston will advance to the second round. So staying in the Midwest, let's look at these potential second-round matchups. I have Illinois, number 1 seed, versus a number 9 seed in Georgia Tech. Illinois advances to the Sweet 16. I have Tennessee, which is your 5 seed. They're going to take on Oklahoma State, which is your 4 seed. I have Tennessee advancing to the Sweet 16. I have San Diego State in the West Virginia matchup. So this is a 6-3 matchup. I got San Diego State. Now, I mean, San Diego State is a very underrated basketball program. They just haven't really been known for basketball or football, for that matter, maybe more football, anything. But lately, though, since they had Coach Fisher years ago, brought that school back up to some sort of relevance when it comes to basketball. But that would be somewhat of an upset if a 6 knock off a 3. Now, in my other brackets, I'm probably going to pick West Virginia. But, I mean, the NCAA tournament is about trying to find the upset. And then you got your buzzer beaters. You got your blowouts, of course, usually between your number 1, 2, 3 seeds playing those lower seeds. But I tell you what. I mean, you're just not going to pick all 4 number 1 seeds or all your number 2 seeds. I mean, the easiest thing you could do is pick your 1, 2, 3, 4 in every region and say, okay, this is it. But now, I mean, it wouldn't be March Madness if you did that, right? So that's why you really got to think about, you know, a team that some of these high seeds that could, you know, and the 6 seed, which is not that bad of a seed. It's very competitive. I mean, you have to earn the right to be a 6 seed. So I got San Diego State beating West Virginia in this bracket, And then I have the Houston team knocking off Rutgers, advancing to the Sweet 16. So now I'm breaking down the Sweet 16 from the Midwest. So you got a Illinois-Tennessee matchup. I got Illinois going to the next round in that. And then you have a San Diego State-Houston matchup. I got the Houston team advancing to the Elite Eight. Now, to advance to the Final Four from the Illinois-Houston matchup, folks, I got the Houston the Cougars advancing to the Final Four. So the Houston team is my Final Four selection, my final selection in the Midwest. So these are my Final Four picks: Gonzaga from the West, Michigan from the East, Baylor from the South, and Houston from the Midwest. All right, so now let's look at the matchup between the West and the East, and this is to advance to the championship game. I have Gonzaga and Michigan. And folks, I tell you what, now Gonzaga coming into this tournament 26-0, and I've already given them three victories here, so they would be 29, trying to win their 30th game here, facing a Wolverines team. This is where the upset comes, folks. I picked the Michigan Wolverines to knock off Gonzaga. Now, no one likes to see a team come into this tournament unbeaten because, you're talking about a target on your back. Now, Gonzaga is a hell of a team, but like I said, they would have been road tested. You know, I don't know if Oklahoma might give them a little run, Creighton to give them a little run, Iowa, maybe. They really got it made in that West region. The heaviest competition is coming from the East region. And I said, you got some powerhouse teams in there. Florida State, Michigan State, Texas, UConn, Alabama, Georgetown, good Lord. So whoever comes out of that East is going to be pretty damn tough. And that's why, and I think it's going to be Michigan. That's why I got Michigan beating Gonzaga for the right to be the first team in the NCAA championship game from on my bracket here. Now, over in the other side, you have the South winner, Baylor, and the Midwest winner I just picked, which was Houston. So, hey, keeping it in the state of Texas, how about that, right? So, this is where I am going to go with Baylor. I think Houston would have made an incredible run, but this Baylor team is no joke, folks. So, I have Baylor beating Houston, okay, for the Battle of Texas is what this is probably going to be billed at if it happens. Baylor advances to the NCAA Tournament Championship game to play Michigan, all right? To play Michigan, all right? That's Mean Gene's tournament bracket, Baylor versus Michigan in the NCAA Tournament Championship game. And I have Baylor, the Baylor Bears, winning the NCAA Tournament. And I do have I'm supposed to give some tiebreaker points here. 155. That's usually the minimum score of a college basketball game. So 155 points there. That's what I got, folks. So the Baylor Bears will win the NCAA tournament according to Mean Gene. That is my bracket. So, hey, I know you're going to submit your brackets. Can't really wait to submit my other brackets because there's just no way you can do one, right? I mean, who does one bracket, okay? And then there's tournament brackets out there where you can win a lot of money and all that great stuff, too. So that's it. That is my 2021 NCAA Men's Tournament bracket. I think this is the first time I ever picked a bracket on one of my shows. So hope I didn't bore you. Hope you found this very interesting. Hope you might even take some of my points here and fill out your brackets, because I think you still have a couple of days or 2 days before things get underway here in the NCAA tournament. So, hey, hope you enjoyed the show, folks. Don't forget some exciting news coming up, too. We are going to move the Mean Gene Show. Well, we're going to stay with the iHeartRadio podcast, but we are certainly in talks with KDWN AM 720 and 101.5 FM in Las Vegas. We will move the Mean Gene Show to the Las Vegas area, which I'm very excited about. So more details coming on that. We will still be on the iHeartRadio format platform, so you can just listen to the show if you're in the Vegas area. You can listen to us on radio there in Las Vegas, as well as iHeartRadio. So hopefully you are ready for the NCAA tournament. And I can't wait to come back next week to break down the first and second rounds of these games to see how we're doing on our bracket. All right, enjoy the rest of your day, and we'll see you back here again on the Mean Gene Show here on iHeartRadio.